Listening Library presents Who Was Celia Cruz? By Pam Pollack and Meg Belviso. Read for you by Frankie Corzo. Para Roberto Ponce Vargas, PP. For Cara, MB. For Tracy, thank you for using the gift of your voice to bring some joy to those around you during difficult times. JM. Who Was Celia Cruz? One Saturday morning in 1947 in Havana, Cuba, Celia Cruz woke up early. It was an exciting day. Earlier that week, her cousin Serafine had surprised her by signing her up for a singing contest. He thought his cousin was talented enough to win. The contest was for a radio show called La Hora del Té, which means tea time. Celia loved listening to the show. Her whole family did. Celia was 22 years old and had loved to sing all her life, but she had never appeared on stage or on the radio. She looked out at her family's backyard and all the other houses on her street. Everything was covered in dew. Celia thought it made her neighborhood sparkle like a sequined gown. She put on a white dress, white tights, and nice white shoes. Her mother combed her dark hair into a bun and fastened it with a beautiful clip. Then Celia and Serafine got on the bus that would take them the 12 blocks to the radio station. In her hands, Celia held her claves, wooden sticks that she tapped together to keep the beat while she sang. When they got to the radio station, there were many other contestants waiting. Most of them were older than Celia. When it was her turn, she sang a song called Nostalgia, tapping her claves as she sang. Once she started to sing, Celia stopped thinking about the other contestants and the competition. She just enjoyed the song. She was completely surprised when she won first prize. For first prize, Celia was given a cake from one of the best bakeries in Havana. When she and Serafine got back on the bus, they placed the cake box carefully on their laps so it would not get crushed. Their family was very poor. They had never had a cake in such a fancy box. They couldn't wait to get home to look at it, so they opened the box on the bus. The cake was covered in white frosting with colorful flowers. It was so delicate, it seemed to be made of lace. Celia and Serafine enjoyed the cake's delicious smell before closing the box again. When they got home, Celia found her whole family waiting for her on the porch. They cheered when they saw her. She opened the box and everyone shared the beautiful cake. Celia never forgot how good it tasted. It wasn't just winning that felt good. Celia had loved singing in the contest. She couldn't wait to do it again. She didn't know that one day, she would sing for crowds all over the world. Chapter 1, Lullabies and Carnival. Celia Cruz was born in Havana, Cuba on October 21, 1925. Her full name was Úrsula Hilaria Celia Caridad Cruz Alfonso. Her father was Simón Cruz, and her mother was Catalina Alfonso, but everyone called her Ollita. Cuba. The Republic of Cuba is the largest island in the Caribbean. Havana is its capital city. The island sits in the spot where the Caribbean Sea, the Atlantic Ocean, and the Gulf of Mexico meet, south of the U.S. state of Florida. The original people of Cuba were the Native American Siboney and Taino. The island was conquered by the Spanish in the late 15th century. It was a Spanish colony until 1898, when it became independent after the Spanish-American War. Cuba is a country with many kinds of people. They include descendants of the original Taino and Siboney, white descendants of the Spanish, and descendants of black slaves brought there from Africa and other islands in the Caribbean. The neighborhood she lived in was very poor. Most of the people who lived there, including Celia and her family, were Black. They were Afro-Cuban, descended from African slaves brought to Cuba by the Spanish, who settled there in the late 15th century. Celia and her family were very close. She was the second oldest of four children. She had an older sister, Dolores, a brother, Bárbaro, and a younger sister, Gladys. One of Celia's aunts, Tia Ana, often treated her like a daughter. Many people lived in the small house in the Santo Suarez district in Havana. The family included not just Celia, her parents, and her siblings, but also her grandmother and many other relatives. Celia's mother often sang while she cooked traditional Cuban dishes, like white rice and black beans, papaya and fried ripe plantains, and ropa vieja, a beef stew whose name means old clothes. Everyone had chores to do. As she got older, one of Celia's was to put all the younger children to bed each night. She had to give them their bath and put them to sleep. Once they were tucked in, she always sang them a lullaby. But Celia's lullabies never put them to sleep. The children always wanted to hear more. Neighbors started to gather outside the window each night. They wanted to listen too. Celia's voice was already drawing crowds in the neighborhood. Sometimes Celia's parents asked her to sing for their friends. Celia was shy, but she loved to sing so much that she got over it to perform. No one loved Celia's singing more than her cousin Serafin. He thought she was good enough to one day sing professionally, but such a dream seemed impossible for a poor Afro-Cuban girl from Havana. Celia's parents were very protective. She wasn't allowed to go out by herself that often. She walked to school with her friends, and when she became a teenager, they went to school dances. But Celia longed to go to Carnival. Every year during Carnival, the streets of Havana filled with people dancing and singing. Carnival. Carnival is a yearly celebration in Havana. It originated in medieval Italy. Carnival celebrates the time before the Catholic season of Lent. During Lent, Catholics are supposed to avoid eating meat, and sometimes they also choose to give up their favorite foods. So Carnival was a big party they had before Lent started. Carnival has been celebrated in Havana since 1573. People paraded down the streets in costume, rode in carriages, and danced. When slaves were brought to Cuba, the Black population eventually joined the parade, adding African instruments and dances. When Celia was 14, she and some of her friends went to Carnival, but Celia didn't tell her parents. She knew that they didn't think it was safe. Her father especially thought that young girls might get into trouble by themselves or even get lost in the crowd. But Celia had a wonderful time. When she got home, she felt very guilty for lying. So the next morning, she confessed what she'd done to her tía Ana. "If you promise not to go out again without an adult," her aunt said, "I'll take you." So Celia got to go back to Carnival the next night. When they got home, Celia's mother winked at them. She knew just where they'd been. That night, Celia had a dream in which she was the queen of Carnival. She saw herself wearing a flowing white gown, her hair pulled back in a bun, and her head topped with a floral crown. When she awoke the next morning, she wondered if her dream could ever come true. Chapter 2. Life Choices. Celia loved to sing, but she knew that when she grew up, she was going to be a teacher. That was her father's dream for her. Teaching was a good, respectable job. When Celia graduated from high school, she entered a teacher's college in Havana. Education in Cuba was free, so Celia did not have to pay to attend. When she was 22 and still in school, she won first prize in a singing contest on the radio. Celia started entering other contests, and sometimes she won. Her prizes were small items like soap, chocolate bars, and condensed milk. To Celia, these gifts were valuable. Although there were some people in Cuba who were rich, most people were poor. It was hard to find jobs. Black Cubans like Celia and her family often had the lowest paying work. Celia's father was a railway worker who shoveled coal to power the trains. He had to support a big family on his salary, not only his own four children and his wife, but also many other relatives who lived with the family at different times. When Celia won 15 pesos, about 80.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.